Thank you, Eshmin, and good evening, everybody. We start the march towards a festive feast of football on TalkSport with a huge game here in the freezing northeast, and the floodlights are on and the skies are dark overhead at St James Park. For Newcastle in midweek, there was Champions League controversy in Paris. For Manchester United, the disappointments of a draw in Istanbul. If the European dream is to end early, then tonight already feels especially important in the race for the top four. A win for either team would take them fifth this weekend. It may only be the start of December, but the Premier League is now really hotting up. Here are the two teams. Newcastle United have Pope in goal, Trippier, Lascelles, Cher and Livramento, Miley, Bruno Guimaraes and Joel Linton in midfield, Almiron and Gordon either side of Isak up front. For Manchester United, Onana is the goalkeeper, Wan-Bissaka, Maguire, Shaw and Dallow are the defenders, McTominay, Bruno Fernandes and Maynou in midfield, Rashford, Martial and Garnacho up front. Local hero rings around St James's Park, a sea of black and white flags. It really is a spectacular sight and sound. And actually at the Leeds end away to our left a few moments ago, they unveiled a huge banner depicting Eddie Howe, who of course is the man tasked with leading Newcastle United on the march again in the Premier League this season and in the Champions League as well. It's a fixture that has plenty of history going back so many years, and Stuart Pearce, as a former Newcastle defender yourself, you know just how passionate this crowd is going to be tonight.
Well, Joe, evening to you. I mean, I hadn't realised the support base behind this football club and this city until I actually got here, believe it or not. At my first game, I can remember it, Sheffield Wednesday at home. It's an incredible atmosphere. And I've got to say, they've rekindled that sort of atmosphere now. It's a brilliant place to come and watch football.
Newcastle players going into a huddle ahead of kick-off, which is just moments away. We know that England will face Serbia, Denmark and Slovenia at next summer's Euros, while Scotland will play the opening game against Germany, as well as facing Hungary and Switzerland. We'll have every game of the tournament live, and you'll hear from Gareth Southgate at half-time. Jeff Stelling takes charge of TalkSport Breakfast on Monday morning from 6, with Graham Souness sparring with White and Jordan every Monday from 10. But first, it's a fixture that so often proves to be a Premier League classic. Newcastle United against Manchester United. We're off and underway, and we're into that most wonderful time of the year. The best place to be, of course, is TalkSport. And an early touch for Jamal Lascelles, the Newcastle captain, out wide to the right back position, and Kieran Trippier. Newcastle in the traditional black and white striped shirts, the black shorts and the white socks, and they're playing from left to right in the first half towards the Gallagate, and there were boos from the home supporters. Presumably Manchester United won the toss and chose to switch ends, so Newcastle attacking the Gallagate in the first half. Manchester United, red shirts, white shorts and black socks, playing from right to left towards the Leeds' end, and atop the Leeds' end are the Manchester United fans high up at the back of the stand. Early touch on the far side of the field for the 17-year-old Lewis Miley. The ball is played backwards now to Fabian Scher with the yellow boots on. High ball towards Isak. Harry Maguire beats him in the air. Our commentary position just 5 rows or so from the front. We're right behind the dugouts of the two managers, Ten Hag and Howe. We're both standing either side of the halfway line, and the atmosphere tremendous early on. The score is 0-0. Bruno Guimaraes, live in the centre circle, looks to the wide positions and the near side of Almiron, but Diogo Dallo is there on the cover to send it back to Andre Onana. Lots of boos and whistles for the Manchester United goalkeeper. He's under real pressure tonight, Stuart Pearce.
Yeah, he certainly is, and Newcastle done exactly as you would expect. Ball back into Onana, and Almiron set sail, got after him, tried to shut him down and belie some of that lack of confidence that people are potentially talking about. I felt, Joe, that Rashford might play on the left-hand side, his more favourable position. He's over on the right, and he's going to be up against Livramento, and obviously Livramento's probably prowess is going forward rather than defending, so that dynamic between those two will be interesting.
Well, Erik ten Hag did say before the game that Rashford is multifunctional positionally. He can play Rashford and Garnacho in the same team. Garnacho starting out on the left, having scored 2 wonderful goals in each of the last 2 matches, that overhead kick away at Everton and then a super finish in what ultimately turned into a disappointing draw for Manchester United in the Champions League in Istanbul. Just over 2 minutes played on TalkSport. Newcastle 0, Manchester United 0. And a throw to Newcastle 10 yards into opposition territory.
I'll tell you what I don't like. Even in these opening gambits of the game, Newcastle have been playing, keeping possession. It's all nice and safe. But sometimes you've got to put the opposition, especially when they're away from home, on the back foot. Get them turned and start to put some pressure on their back line.
Joel Linton down by the corner flag, tries to cut it back infield. Harry Maguire will sweep it away from danger for Manchester United all the way to the halfway line. Newcastle send it back to goalkeeper Pope in that short-sleeved lime green kit. We're wrapped up warm tonight in the commentary box, that's for sure. Although it's only our producer who's got the heated gilet.
Well, he obviously gets paid a lot more than you and I, Joe.
I wouldn't be surprised. Back goes the ball to the goalkeeper, Pope, again. Nil-nil in the very early stages on a busy day in the Premier League, of course. Wins early for Arsenal, the league leaders. Brentford over Luton, a big win for Burnley. 5-0 against the 10 men of Sheffield United. And a vital victory for Everton away at Nottingham Forest in the 5:30. Here come Newcastle playing the ball out of the back line, and it's Livramento driving forward towards halfway. Over the halfway line he goes. He's got support in the shape of Gordon to his left. Back to Livramento, left hand edge of the penalty area. He'll whip in the cross, high to the far post, missed by Dallow. Almiron maybe wasn't expecting it to come through to him. He does control on the corner of the 18-yard area. Back infield to the 17-year-old Lewis Miley, who's making quite the impression for Newcastle. Almiron into the D. Does he get it back from Joel Linton here? Joel Linton's lofted ball into the penalty area. There's an awkward and clumsy one. Manchester United with lots of red shirts behind the ball as Newcastle play from left to right towards the famous Gunner Gate in the first half. And there were lots of replays on the big screens before the game of memorable Newcastle goals in this fixture in years gone by. Alan Shearer, Philippe Albert, Johan Cabaye. Here's Trippier for Newcastle, gives it away on the corner of the penalty area. Good interception by Diogo Dalot. Great energy and tenacity in these early stages. Still goalless, Stuart Pearce.
Yeah, we just saw earlier there Livramento driving forward and Rashford no desire at all to get back and track him back. So that dynamic will be interesting.
Scott McTominay up in the centre circle for Manchester United. Wide right to Rashford, is wearing gloves tonight. Scampers in field, edge of the penalty area. Wriggles away from one, but not beyond Bruno Guimarães, who stops him in his tracks. Almost nonchalantly there, the Brazilian. Whips it off the toes of Marcus Rashford and sends it back to goalkeeper Nick Pope. Rashford, who's back after a European ban in midweek. Now Cher. On the edge of his own penalty area. Forward to Isak, who drops deep and spins away from Maguire. Absolutely left him for dead. Isak over the halfway line, wide left to Gordon. Gordon is 5 yards on the edge of the penalty area. 0-0 the score. Isak, edge of the D. Thought about a shot. Looks menacing here. Miley plays it square to his left and Joel Linton. Still 30, 35 yards or so from goal, Newcastle here. And Livramento hugging that far side left touchline in front of the East Stand. Back it goes to Jamal Lascelles inside the centre circle. Newcastle building neatly here.
Top quality play there by Isak, just on that turn with Maguire. Left him for absolute dead then and opened up the back line of United.
Livramento past Rashford with ease to the dead ball line. He'll pull it back. It takes a deflection. It goes behind for a Newcastle corner. The Gallagher gets to its feet. It's 0-0.
That's exactly what Livramento's got to do. It's the trade-off. I've got to deal with Rashford defensively. You understand that. But you've got to drive Rashford back into his own half defensively. And he was awful then, Rashford, I've got to say. And if Livramento can get doubling up with Gordon, who's one of the form players in the Premier League, I've got to say.
This is Livramento's second Premier League start for Newcastle, having featured in that thumping win over Chelsea and a great home record that they've got so far this season, Newcastle. 6 wins from 7, the only blemish, a defeat to Liverpool. Now it's Kieran Trippier, of course it is, to take the corner. It'll be right-footed and in-swinging, right underneath the crossbar. Onana flaps it at the goalkeeper, diving high up into the air, got nowhere near it. Manchester United clear through Dallow, throw to Newcastle in front of the home dugout. That was a nervy piece of goalkeeping from Onana. Arms outstretched over his head, but wasn't anywhere near the ball, Stuart Pearce.
No, I think it was a vain attempt in trying to buy a free kick, to be honest with you. He literally threw his arms out and jumped chest first into the Newcastle striker, but the referee wasn't having any of it.
He is the Manchester United goalkeeper, in fairness, the man to have kept 3 successive clean sheets in the Premier League. Manchester United's longest run of league clean sheets and since early 2021. Almiron with the ball back over the halfway line into his own territory, and now the giant Swiss defender Cher. That's a lovely, clever, lofted pass into the feet of Trippier. Trippier early down the inside right channel. Almiron herring after it. He's got the pace to keep it in play with his yellow boots. Whips it into the box and it's cleared away. Not entirely convincingly by Wan-Bissaka. Hooks it out of play. And a throw to Newcastle right by the corner flag. 0-0, 7.5 gone. But Newcastle have started the better on TalkSport.
Yeah, United have got into their stride now. A wonderful ball. Brilliant fullback's ball down the line for Almiron. Two runners looking to exploit in behind. And that's the type of ball that will hurt United's back line.
Stuart Pearce, a former Newcastle defender. The ball is down by the corner flag. Cobby Mayne, who gets a tackling for Manchester United. Loose ball breaks for Bruno Guimaraes. Tried to bend it with the outside of his foot. Blocked by Harry Maguire. It's come out to Cher. Cries of shoot. Oh, he's played it forward beautifully to Isak, who couldn't get it under control. Angle was tied on the corner of the six-yard box. He couldn't quite pluck it out of the dark night sky. And it's through to Onana again.
Well, Cher has played a couple of delightful passes, one to Trippier just earlier, and that one was even better. Just floated it with a little bit of guile into the box, and to be fair to Isak, he should have done slightly better, I think, Joe.
A great speed and precision in the build-up from Newcastle, and a lot of people did say, Stuart, didn't they, that trip to Paris and the manner of the draw, as you said, not necessarily a bad point at all away at Paris Saint-Germain, but the manner of it, I think, was what was so disappointing. Of course, as we all know, all of that VAR controversy earlier in the week, but Newcastle looked very fleet-footed and very fresh tonight, despite being unchanged.
Yeah, they do, and as I say, every time they take the field in front of their own fans, there's a real lift amongst the team.
Gordon driving up the middle, he's up to the edge of the penalty area, trying to thread it through. Oh, and Dallow's made a mistake, and he clears it away from in front of goal. Miscommunication between Dallow and Onana. Dallow very nearly turned it into his own net, but recovered to clear it away.
I think there was a big call for a penalty there. I think Dallow got it so badly wrong, he chipped it onto his own hand, but how that could be deemed as intentional, I'll never know.
Well, given what we saw on Tuesday, Dallow trying to tap it back to Onana, and he knocks it straight onto his lower forearm. But of course, I think it's right that that isn't going to be given as a penalty.
No,
Stuart.
It takes some doing to chip it onto your own arm, actually. You know what I mean? So
quite impressive from that angle. Stuart Pearce is with us tonight. As Onana clears high and long, you're listening to TalkSport. Newcastle 0, Manchester United 0. In the 10th minute of the game, on the day where we discovered the Euro 2024 draw, England will play Denmark, Slovenia and Serbia at the Euros. Manchester United on the attack with Garnacho, bursting into the box, great pace, angle tight, went for goal at the near post, and Pope made the save with his leg. His right leg to turn it away, up into the air. Trippier gets the loose ball. Robbed by Garnacho down by the corner flag. Garnacho then goes down. The referee has signalled for a Manchester United throw about 10 yards or so from the corner flag. Electric pace from Garnacho. Could he have done better? Could he have broken the deadlock there?
Well, personally, I think once he'd got away, I think it's a two-touch finish. One to drag it probably to his left. And secondly, just to hammer it with a left foot across the goalkeeper. He's ended up getting Trippier, managed to get some sort of distance back on it, but certainly a good pass, that is for sure.
Manchester United on the ball now with Maguire. A square to Shaw. Shaw, the left-sided centre-half tonight. Lindelof and Varane are both on the bench. Erik ten Hag watches on in a dark overcoat and a flat cap. Eddie Howe in the tracksuit to the right of the halfway line. He was taking copious notes earlier, was Eddie Howe. And Newcastle defending the loser's end in the first half. The ball is back with Lascelles in black and white. Drives it forward high to the halfway line. Intercepted with ease by Shaw. Chests it forward to Bruno Fernandes. Floats it high to the left and Maynou. Maynou controls the 18-year-old. His second Premier League start tonight. Here is Garnacho. Back to Maynou, the number 37. All the play on the near side, the left for Manchester United. Garnacho skips away from Trippier. Gets the dead ball line. Drives into the box. Tries to pull it back to Martial. And well blocked by a retreating Trippier. Who got back into position. Dallow's kept it in play for Manchester United. Still 0-0. Maynou square to Bruno Fernandes. A lively start to the game. Lovely ball by Bruno Fernandes. Threaded up the left-hand side. He's found Dallow in acres of space. Dallow had time to measure the cross. And that's hit Trippier where it hurts, I think.
Yeah, Trippier's had a couple of lively moments just recently that shook his confidence a little bit. That ball in behind. And then he'd been taken on by Garnacho. And you certainly know as a fullback in the early stages of a game, the last thing you want is your winger in behind you on two occasions.
We'll bring you Gareth Southgate's reaction to England's Euros draw at half time on TalkSport. Scotland will face Germany in the opening game, Hungary and Switzerland in their Group A. As Garnacho gets the ball for Manchester United again and breaks into the box, he pulls it back to the edge of the penalty area. Wan-Bissaka takes a touch and shoots low. That one's blocked by Joel Linton, who's got some strapping on his right hand. Now Dalot in the left wing position, blocked off by Almiron, tackled by Almiron. That's a throw to Manchester United, 0-0, but encouragement for Erik ten Hag.
Well, I think there's encouragement for both sets of attacks here. They both shown that they can probably cause problems to the opposition's defence.
It was the sense this was going to be quite an open game. Garnacho with a reverse ball in from the left, and he's got that all wrong. He sliced it behind, and the ironic cheers of the Newcastle fans tell you all you need to know. And Wales, by the way, if they get through the playoffs, will have a tough group at the Euros. Netherlands, France and Austria. Reaction to all of that and the weekend's football starts on Monday morning with Jeff Stelling, the new TalkSport breakfast host, superstar breakfast. He'll be on Monday and Tuesday mornings with Ali McCoys. Cannot wait. Monday at 6, it all gets underway. And there's so much festive football on the TalkSport network as well. We've got 50 games over the festive period. As the ball is sent back to Onana, and again the whistles and the boos of the Newcastle supporters, all eyes on Andre Onana every time he's in possession. Composure to find Shaw from the goalkeeper this time. Shaw feeds Dalot in the left-back spot, and Dalot draws the tackle from Miley, and that goes out of play at the expense of a throw to Manchester United. Lots of Newcastle fans packed all around us in the commentary position. It's loud in the northeast. Livramento bursting forward up the middle like he loves to do. Then tries to cut back onto his weaker right side, and McTominay was there to make a tackle. Rashford jinking away from Joel Linton, brought down on the halfway line. Referee says no foul, he says play on.
Yeah, that'll be interesting watching Joel Linton covering into that area.
Quarter of an hour gone and it's still 0-0. Not for the want of trying though from both teams. Bruno Guimaraes, corner of the penalty area. Right to the left, and Gordon in field, going to get it back from Bruno Guimaraes here. Good covering by Wan-Bissaka, knew where the ball was going to be going. Tracked his runner all the way. A scramble clearance though. Newcastle have it back with Cher, driving forward, urge to shoot. Cher into the penalty area. Gordon lays it back now to Miley. Touch forward by Trippier, well controlled by Isak. Isak might get a shot away here, angle against him, shoots. Well blocked by Shaw. Shaw dropping it impressively there, and Arna was able to pounce on the loose ball.
Joe, I've got to tell you, that is top quality defending by Luke Shaw. There, you're isolated, you're one-on-one in the box with a striker who's looking to manipulate the shot and play it through you or around you, and you just kept an eye on the ball and dealt with it brilliantly.
Mighty's intercepted though, and here's Bruno Guimaraes bursting into the box, and it goes loose to Gordon, left-footed, and that's straight at Andre Onana. The flag was up anyway on the near side. This is the Milburn side of the ground, that shepherd flag. It'll be a free kick to Manchester United, and you're absolutely right, Stuart, because people might pinpoint this back four and say, look, he's the player playing out of position, but actually Manchester United are delighted to have him back because he spent a long part of this season out injured.
He's been a big part of why United don't do well. If you look at the stats, when they're not doing particularly well, chances are he's copped an injury at some stage.
And he's only recently returned to the team after the injury, as I say, that have kept him out since August. Here is Shaw on the ball now, inside the penalty area, back to Onana. Onana safety first. High hanging clearance up to the midway point of his own half, met by Miley's thumping header. Miley, the fearless Miley. Just his seventh senior appearance tonight. Looks like he's already played over 100 games.
The confidence of these kids when you throw them in is quite incredible. You know, it's testament to the academy system, I think.
And now here's Almiron, infield to Joel Linton, edge of the penalty area. Back up wide to Trippier on the near side, the Newcastle right. 0-0, forward to Joel Linton, pulls it back. Almiron, good save down low by Onana. Plunging to his right-hand side, and we saw there the best of the Manchester United goalkeeper. It had to be the best.
We've seen about three or four forward passes that have bisected the back line of each team that have been absolutely top quality.
Some elegant football from Newcastle as Miley's deflected cross loops into the air. It's gathered by Onana at the near post. And I tell you what, that's a confidence-boosting save for the Manchester United goalkeeper, all in green. Almiron tried to place it into the corner, and Onana gets down well to save.
Yeah, Joe Linton's movement magnificent there, and he's pulled the ball back to Almiron, just falling back. He's ended up, probably didn't get enough power in it, Joe, I would say.
Onana was in the way. 0-0 the score. That's the first serious effort on target of the game. Live on TalkSport. We've got the Sunday session back for you tomorrow. Adrian Durham will take you around the grounds. A big day of Premier League football tomorrow. Some really intriguing games, including Manchester City against Tottenham. That's where Adrian will be based for the show. And England's cricket tour of the Caribbean underway tomorrow on TalkSport 2 and our new cricket YouTube channel. Livramento breaking up the left-hand channel. Rashford out of position. And Wan-Bissaka too. Livramento's into the box. He's still going. He shoots right-footed. It's blocked. Now Gordon lays it off to Bruno Guimaraes. Only a couple of yards over the top. That was so close to finding the top corner. Livramento had acres and acres of space. I'm not sure where the right-hand side of Manchester United was there. It was missing in action.
Well, it is because Rashford doesn't see that part of his job, to be honest with you. And he's up against a very attack-minded fullback that's going to gallop on, and he's been in the advanced area probably on four occasions now. And once Livramento got forward and he just was faced with Maguire, if I was him, I'd have just run at Maguire at that stage and made him make a challenge.
Well, where was Marcus Rashford?
Waiting for the counter-attack.
Yes, perfectly placed for the transition, for sure. And Martial trying to reach a loose ball down the middle. We haven't seen anything of Manchester United's number 9 in the game so far. Newcastle have had most of the possession, and both sides have played some good football. Lofted pass by the Sells down the near side to Trippier. Trippier tattoos down his arms, controls, tries to reverse ball up the near side channel. It's blocked by the chest of Dallow. Despite the calls of the Newcastle fans for handball, it thundered off his chest. Here though goes Almiron, put through into the penalty area, pokes it square, only half cleared, Isak! Oh, he's rolled it wide! Should have scored, took a deflection, quarter to Newcastle United, should have been 1-0.
Well, I was just talking momentarily earlier about that ball that gets played in behind. It's another magnificent pass that's bisected the United back line. Miley on that occasion. And just the faintest of deflections has taken the effort from Isak wide.
Do not take your ears away from this. 0-0 on Talk Sports. 19 and a half minutes gone. And again, the Gallagher gets to its feet. A corner for Newcastle United. Trippier standing over. Plenty of aerial ability in this Newcastle side. The two centre-halves are forward. Trippier square with the corner. To Almiron. Corner of the box. Back it goes now to Livramento. Thought about a shot. Goes wide instead to the opposite flank and Gordon. Gordon with the red boots on. Whips it in high. Chair gets up. And then Isak with his back to goal. The Sells! Header over the top from inside the six-yard box. The flag stayed down. And the chances are really racking up for Newcastle United. But they can't find the breakthrough yet.
Well, we've got a magnificent game against two teams that have got aspirations to finish in the Champions League. Both of them obviously playing in there at the moment, but they want to be in there again next year. But they're certainly going head-to-head, and it's Newcastle who've just got the ascendancy on chances.
Oh, it's a thriller, and Onana might be in trouble here. The referee signalling, you're time-wasting, he points to his wrist, does the referee Rob Jones, and Maguire's tying his shoelaces inside the penalty area, and the Newcastle fans, 50,000 or so of them are on their feet, and Jason Tindall's having words with the fourth official, the assistant manager, Eric Ten Hag, having none of it, and we'll get back underway.
Well, the incredible thing is, if Onana's about to take a goal kick, if Maguire wants to bend down and tie his laces up, that's his prerogative. He's not wasting time. It's the goalie that's got the ball at his feet.
And Onana eventually just clattered the ball high into the freezing air tonight, very cold. Newcastle on the attack with Joel Linton, the number 7, up the left-hand channel. Every time Newcastle get the ball inside opposition territory, up goes the roar of the home fans. Livramento down by the dead ball line, doesn't quite get to it quick enough to keep it in play. And Manchester United have got themselves a goal kick. Tino is the chant from the Newcastle supporters, already warming to the man who was brought in the summer. Newcastle 0, Manchester United 0 on TalkSport with Now. Don't forget that with Now you can stream all the Sky Sports action, like West Ham against Crystal Palace, Man City beat Tottenham, live tomorrow for £11.99, no contract. Search Now Sports. We're nearly halfway through the first half as Onana slips while taking the goal kick. And what have you made of it, Stuart Pearce?
Well, I think it's exactly what we're expecting, a really open game. Both defences struggling to deal with either attack, and probably United United, they're both United. Newcastle United have probably, certainly had more chances and looked more threatening to score a goal. But certainly United have got enough in that front line to cause big, big problems.
Here's Bruno Fernandes for Manchester United, shy of the halfway line. Lovely ball, the outside of his foot, put it up the left-hand side, and Trippier slides in to beat Garnacho to the ball. Newcastle fans out of their seats in roaring approval. Can see the Manchester United fans and their thousands right at the very top of the Leeds' end. I think it's over 120 steps or something like that to get up there. We've got views of the city centre as well as the pitch. It's that high up. Here is Maynou for Manchester United, dropping deep to the halfway line. And for once, that's the first time in the game, halfway through the first half, they're at a walking pace.
It is. I think both teams have gone at each other in these first 20-odd minutes.
It's been very enjoyable.
It's been magnificent.
Bruno Fernandes trying to throw the ball up the inside right channel. Rashford had made the run, cleared away by Livramento on the cover. Harry Maguire there to the loose ball on the halfway line. Bruno Fernandes forward to Scott McTominay. McTominay controls, 30 yards out. In great form internationally, McTominay. And certainly in not bad form for Manchester United either. Another goal in the Champions League in midweek for McTominay. As Newcastle clear through Miley. Albion with his quick feet skips over the halfway line. It's three against three. Gordon to the left. Plays it through towards Gordon. Good cover by Bruno Fernandes, the captain, to stop it from reaching Gordon.
We've had some brilliant bisecting passes that have gone beyond the back line, and that weren't one of them. And that was probably the best option in the game for Elmer on there. Just to slide the ball beyond the back line for Gordon, but he just got his pass too short.
Well, Newcastle, who since the League Cup final defeat in February have beaten Manchester United twice, including in the League Cup at Old Trafford just a few weeks ago. Rashford on the far side right channel for Manchester United. It's end to end at the moment. Looks to play it forward to the overlapping Wan-Bissaka. That's a careless pass, a discourteous pass from Rashford. Overhit and out of play.
Yeah, there's nothing worse from a fullback's point of view when you've run 100 yards to go beyond your wide player and his pass is either cut out or too far that goes out of play. I'm just looking at United's ranks as well and for their recruitment in January, and the only person probably in United's ranks that has probably not done a great deal early on is probably Martial, isn't it? You'd want more from your centre forward. Isak's played a big part in United Newcastle's start to the game, but certainly Martial's not really been involved in the game.
Two goals so far this season for Martial. His last coming last weekend away at Everton in that comfortable 3-0 victory. 0-0 tonight on TalkSport at St James's Park. 25 minutes gone. We've got more live football than anybody else on national radio. As McTominay makes an interception, but Almiron went down earlier on in the move. Looked to the referee. No free kick given. Anana clears. The flick by Rashford down the middle. The interception on the stretch with his long leg by Scher to win it back.
Gotta say, the referee's played his part in this game as well in letting it flow.
Gordon is away down the left-hand side. Joel Linton calling for it, and it hasn't quite reached him. Scrambled away by Bruno Fernandes. Manchester United exposed on their right-hand side again.
They are, as I say, the galloping Livramento is causing that overload on that side of the pitch. And Wan-Bissaka, whilst he's an outstanding defender, one-on-one, two-on-one, not so good.
Bruno Guimaraes plays a 1-2 with Isak. He's 25 yards from goal, right of centre. Lots of red Manchester United shirts blocking the way. Here is Almiron, infield to Bruno Guimaraes, swings in the right-footed cross, only half cleared by Manchester United, but the loose ball is retrieved by Shaw. And now Rashford back to Wan-Bissaka, had to turn back to reach it. Maynou infield on the corner of the penalty area. Good sharp control by Rashford in a very tight area. Wan-Bissaka wins the throw, but the Newcastle fans, you can hear them roaring their approval of the press, the high press from Gordon this time.
Newcastle have had some plaudits this year and some criticism for being a little bit overly aggressive. I think that's a major card Newcastle have to play in a game like this against United. Be a little bit aggressive in the tackle, and that will end up bringing them out on top, I think, on the scoreline if they are.
Well, look, we've seen this sort of thing, haven't we, at home this season in the Premier League. We've seen it in the Champions League for Newcastle as well, most memorably against PSG here. The ball is with Trippier, deep inside the Manchester United half, forward to Miley, down the right-hand channel, near side, he's about 10 yards from the corner flag, infield to Almiron, tries the first-time pass, intercepted by Dallow. The only surprise, given how open and enterprising the game has been, is that it's still 0-0. 27 minutes have flown by. And here is Cher inside the centre circle, out to the left-hand side, and Livramento, who looks up and for once slows the game down as he waits for a teammate to provide support. Cher does just that, angles it wide to the left-hand side, and Joel Linton, who sprints forward to keep it in play in front of Maynou. Back he goes to Livramento now. Everybody inside the Manchester United half, bar the Newcastle goalkeeper Pope. It's Onana who's had to make the one save that we've seen in the game so far. The one, a serious save, really.
And I think because of that stat, it probably tells you the final ball, the final finish has not been as clinical as it could have been, I think.
Here is Trippier. Into the centre circle, forward now to Bruno Guimaraes. He tucks it on to Miley. Miley inside the penalty area, dead ball line, tries to drive it back across. Blocked by Shaw. That's a corner. Newcastle 0, Manchester United 0. The latest odds from Betfair, the official betting partner of TalkSport's Premier League coverage right now. Newcastle United to win, rather, at 5-4 odds on. Manchester United to win at 7-2. Back the draw at 12-5. Don't forget, Betfair are paying out winning bets at 90 minutes with 90-minute payout, applies to match odds, 90 market or markets with the 90 icon. That's all thanks to Betfair. Trippier to take the corner for Newcastle. Everybody back for Manchester United. It's on the near side in front of the Gallagates. A couple of flags and banners behind the goal. Lofted in high by Trippier. Onana gets a punch on it. It's dropped down to Lascelles. Back it goes to Gordon. Edge of the box. Gordon steers it wide to the near side and Trippier again. How's the delivery this time? It's a good one. Headed away though by Martial for Manchester United through a crowd. And now Rashford is on the break, using his pace, driving it over the halfway line towards Garnacho. Livramento there on the cover. So speedy in front of Garnacho, who throws a his arms in frustration.
Yeah, you can certainly put the afterburners on then, and magnificent acceleration.
And Martial is fouled, and that's a free kick to Manchester United now in a dangerous position about 5 yards from the corner of the penalty area. What a day of football we've seen in the Premier League. Arsenal top and stay top after the win over Wolves. Brentford 3, Luton 1, Burnley 5, Sheffield United 0. That piles the pressure on Paul Heckingbottom. Big win for Everton at Forest. And Leicester still top of the Championship after winning at West Brom. That a game that we brought you live on TalkSport earlier. Ipswich hot on their heels and Leeds in third. Now then, Shaw and Bruno Fernandes over the free kick here.
If anything, I'm seeing probably Fernandes whipping one in. In swing, dropping it just sort of inside the penalty box.
And Maguire and McTominay are both forward here for Manchester United. Short to deliver, high left footed, and that's taken easily by Pope. Just floated towards the 6 yard line, and an easy take for the goalkeeper.
Yeah, it certainly was. Pope read that well. As I say, he was off his line quickly, and there was no pressure on him whatsoever. Dealt with it very, very well. And say, that's the only criticism I would give of Newcastle. They've breached the United back line, I would have said probably on 5 occasions now, but have not found the pullback or a finish once they've got in.
And that is maybe partly why, with half an hour gone, it's still 0-0 beneath the floodlights here. Deep forward by Bruno Fernandes up the right-hand edge of the penalty area. The tall McTominay controls. Back he goes to Wan-Bissaka. Wan-Bissaka then shuffles in field. Bruno Fernandes, the number 8, looks up, thinks about picking a pass, holds on to possession, goes back to Harry Maguire. Now Wan-Bissaka gets the pass from Maynou. Wan-Bissaka back in field to Maynou again. On to McTominay. Back to Maynou. All of this taking place in the middle of the Newcastle half. Newcastle content to invite Manchester United forward. Plenty behind the ball for the team in black and white. 0-0 it remains. A win tonight for either team would take them fifth in the Premier League, ahead of tomorrow's games, of course. Lots of football, and we'll have the Sunday session to take you around the grounds on TalkSport with Adrian Durham. Now Rashford looking to reach the pass down the right-hand channel. He swings it across. Garnacho waiting for it far post, and a brilliant covering header away by Kieran Trippier this time.
Well, you summed it up brilliantly there. It come to the far post, and I thought Garnacho was going to get his head on it, and Trippier just got in front of him and just flicked it on, helped it on its way.
Very clever defensive header from Trippier. Stuart Pearce alongside in the commentary box, right behind the two dugouts here at St James's Park. Joel Linton prods the ball wide to Almiron, all left foot coming infield from the right. Square to the number 7, Joel Linton again. And now Bruno Guimaraes back to halfway, and Cher at walking pace. Cher had just looked shorn of options for a moment. It's Trippier near side the right hand channel. Eddie Howe and Jason Tindall in conversation just a few rows down below us. Now Cher once again. And the game has slowed down momentarily as Cher thunders the ball high and long. It'll be headed away by Wan-Bissaka, not the best of headers. Drops to Isak. Isak edge of the box, tries to place it. And he's placed it wide of goal.
Yeah. The one criticism I would have of Isak, I think he's done brilliant with his hold-up plays. Got turned on occasion. Got himself in a really good position. And right then, he's on the edge of the box. He's one-on-one with Maguire. And he's not made the goalkeeper or Maguire work for their wages. And he's got to do better than that. If I was playing now, probably up against Harry, I would be asking him questions, drive at him, moving your body to and fro and try and unhinge him.
And 7 goals in 9 in the Premier League this season for Isak. We've got the draw for the third round of the FA Cup tomorrow, by the way, on the TalkSport network. A big story in the second round today, the National League South team Maidstone beating Barrow, who are high flyers in League 2. Manchester United in possession with Wan-Bissaka approaching the edge of the penalty area. 0-0 away at Newcastle United in the 34th minute. It's Bruno Fernandes. Whips the ball high into the box towards Martial. Good covering header again by Trippier. It's dropped down to the edge of the 18-yard area, but Wan-Bissaka's layoff was a little nonchalant towards Rashford. It was cleared away. Maguire's won it back though high up the pitch, industriously from Gordon. And now Bruno Fernandes in a central position, forward to Martial, the number 9, with his back to goal. It's touch square to Dallow. Dallow left on edge of the box. Back in field to Bruno Fernandes again. Whips it crossfield. Lovely ball. Wan-Bissaka first time crosses the poor one. Straight into the chest of Pope. But good build-up play for Manchester United.
Yeah, very good. Fernandes' ball was excellent to Wan-Bissaka. If I was him, I'd have probably taken 2 touches there rather than try to deal with it on the volley across the face of goal where there was no United players up in advance.
They've won their last 4 away in the Premier League at Manchester United, but suddenly they're on the back foot here. Newcastle coming forward. Almiron in the penalty area, twisting, turning onto his left foot. Screamer curled over the top. He was played through by Trippier. Dancing feet. Shaw and Dello trying to keep up with him. Almiron got the shot away but didn't trouble Onana.
Well, add that to the list of another one where they've got entries into the penalty box. And when Almiron's opened his body up, he's just not steadied himself enough to guide it into that far corner. You've got defenders there. Their purpose is to be a guide, to be a blocker to the goalie and a guide for you to go round. And they've just not got it on target. And that's been the case this first half.
Pretty breathless the first half. Can both teams keep up this level of intensity? I guess Newcastle in particular, because of the injuries they've got, don't have many options on the bench really either. Dallow's got the ball inside his own penalty area. Manchester United determined to play the ball out of the defensive third. In the end, Maguire scoops it high and long. He's intercepted by Lascelles. Joel Linton trying to bring it out of the air. He gets the turn pass from Bruno Guimaraes and a little flick by Isak back towards Joel Linton. But there on the cover was Luke Shaw. 0-0 on TalkSport with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Enterprise has 450 branches with all the vehicles for your business needs. It's Bruno Guimaraes again. Middle of midfield. Plays it square to Cher. Cher looks up. 9.5 minutes of the first half to go and it's 0-0. Out to the left and Livramento. Suddenly at walking pace. Manchester United with everybody back behind the ball. Infield though to Bruno Guimaraes. Got the run on Martial. In the end, Martial did just enough. McTominay. And it's given away though by Manchester United. Riskily in the defensive third. He's sat with his back to goal. He's on the edge of the penalty area. Square to Miley. Miley urged to shoot. On to Almiron. Almiron corner of the penalty area, red shirts all around him, back to Trippier, crossfield, headed away by Rashford. That went all the way along the edge of the 18-yard line, and actually well defended in the end by Manchester United.
Yeah, the setup play's been so good by both teams, more so Newcastle, but it's just that work in the finish, and they haven't been able to do that as clinically. Well, to match their build-up play in many ways.
We'll hear from Gareth Southgate, the England boss, at half-time. All the reaction to England's Euro 2024 draw. They'll be in Group C with Denmark, Slovenia and Serbia. Cher for Newcastle, darting up the middle. Finds Isak back to goal. It was tripped with Cher. Free kick, just left of centre, about 25 yards out. And that is very much within shooting range.
Yeah, it is. I think Manchester United are riding their luck a little bit here. You know, players are going past them, runners are going past them, they're getting in behind their back line, but It's more the ineptitude probably of a real clinical finish that has kept the score to nil.
Well, Kieran Trippier's there, Stuart, isn't he? But I think Cher really fancies this. He can hammer them from range too.
Yeah, he's a big plus being back in the side, Cher, isn't he?
Yeah, he's been super for Newcastle. Outstanding this season. And he's placed the ball down. And Cher, who has scored in the Champions League this season, his last Premier League goal was on the first weekend of last season. Now, that was against Nottingham Forest, if you remember that, from miles out. Now, this free kick's in front of the Gallagates. It's 25 yards from goal and left of centre as we look at it. Manchester United not only have got four men in the wall, five, maybe two. There's a draft excluder there lying on the ground. I think it's Garnacho. And free kicks were a big problem for Onana on Wednesday night in Istanbul. He conceded two of them.
Yeah, you would definitely be looking to get this on target. One thing we probably need to establish as well, Joe, I can't remember what I had for breakfast this morning, let alone a free kick a season ago.
That's what commentators do, I'm afraid. We're that dull. Trippier and Cher standing over it. 25 yards out, 0-0 the score. Live on TalkSport in the 39th minute here. Newcastle free kick danger now. Kieran Trippier curls it! Off the bar! And Onana grabs the loose ball. So nearly placed perfection by Kieran Trippier. That rattled the woodwork. Goalkeeper rooted to the spot. Nothing he could have done about that one.
Well, wonderful, wonderful free kick. The goalkeeper give up on it. I think it's almost hit either the crossbar or the angle of both. We're seeing the replay now. And it's cannoned down off the underside of the bar and onto the goal line, or just in front and out again.
And now here they come again, the team in black and white. Isak's giving it away, straight to Harry Maguire. And Maguire has the ball on the edge of the penalty area. Well, all of Manchester United's preparation, the defensive wall, could have done nothing about that. We know how much of a set-piece specialist Kieran Trippier is when he gets in that sort of range. Not scored this season, actually, Trippier. Joel Linton, front of the penalty area, almost finding Bruno Guimaraes with a darting run in field. Manchester United clear through Shaw. Rashford, great pace. Oh, he couldn't play it through towards Garnacho. We've made the run over the halfway line, and it's back with Trippier again. Oh, this is great stuff on TalkSport. This is just what we love about the Premier League. It's end-to-end stuff. Newcastle coming forward again. Almer on edge of the box. Tries to flick it through the middle. Straight through it goes to Onana. 0-0 hits Stuart Pearce again.
Yeah, it's just the execution once again. Almeron's done brilliantly. He's cut inside. The goal opened up, all of a sudden there's a gap in front of him. He's trying to feed a little delicate chip ball in. For me, get it at your feet and look to guide it with a bit of curl and a bit of guile into the far corner.
It's a great time to be listening to TalkSport. 50 live games over the festive period. The return of game day next Saturday, including Crystal Palace against Liverpool, Blackburn against Leeds, and Wolves against Nottingham Forest. And all the reaction to this weekend's football from Monday morning at 6, your new breakfast host, Jeff Stelling, with Ali McCoist on Mondays and Tuesdays. And every Monday with White and Jordan on 10 till 1, Graham Souness will be in the studio. Souness sparring with Jordan every Monday.
This is why Manchester United are such a tough opponent, I think. They've been on the back foot for the vast majority of this game. They've rode their luck on occasion. They've defended when they've had to. And they've had a couple of chances to counter-attack, and if it wasn't for a ball being cut out by Trippier, then Garnacho's in behind from a ball from Rashford, and that's how dangerous they are on the counter-attack.
4.5 minutes of the first half remaining, and it is still intriguingly poised. High-angled ball from Cher, deep into opposition territory. Trippier trying to evade Dallow. He's been helped out by Almiron down by the corner flag, and Almiron is so quick-footed, little pirouette from an impossible angle to win a throw off Dallow.
You've just seen the difference between the two sides here. United will go and pressure you, hurry you and put pressure on you. At the front end of the team, Martial and Rashford, I don't think they want any physical encounters in turning sort of average balls into good balls.
What an elegant turn that was from Almiron, but in the end, and Newcastle concede a throw themselves in the Manchester United left-back position. A little bit of movement in the stands at St James's as it continues to get colder here. All wrapped up warm in the press box. Dallow will take the throw. On to Martial. Martial can only flick it into the path of Lascelles. Back to Cher, who's about 6 yards into Manchester United territory. You can see the warm breath of the players. That's how cold it is tonight. Cold snap throughout the country. Joel Linton back to goal, up 10 yards from the corner of the penalty area, trying to dribble away from Bruno Fernandes. He's reached the dead ball line here. Joel Linton shrugged aside the defender, pulled it back. Isak has rolled it wide. The assistant eventually signals for a goal kick. Manchester United, I think, thought the ball was already out of play when it was pulled back.
Well, Fernandes sort of gave up on it, didn't he? He was convinced it had gone out of play, put his arm up and almost stopped.
Well, we've seen controversy this season, balls out of play or not in games at St James's Park involving Newcastle, all that. And controversy in the Arsenal game here, game that Newcastle won. 0-0 so far tonight, late in the first half. With the views of Gareth Southgate to come on TalkSport after England's draw for Euro 2024. Here comes Livramento darting down the left-hand side and now driving infield to the corner of the penalty area. Low ball in, takes deflection into the side netting. Onana probably had it covered. Corner to Newcastle United.
Once again, once Livramento's burst down that left-hand side, for me, if you're facing up Harry Maguire, I'd probably just go and take him on. But he was unfortunate, I've got to say. It's a fair effort to get the ball across, and Maguire's just got his size 10s, 11s, 12s in the way. Got a touch on it.
He had to use all of his right boot there, and it spun into the side netting. So a corner to Newcastle, and they've flooded the six-yard box with those black and white shirts in front of Onana. Oh, Cher's gone down inside the six-yard area, a bit theatrically. Helped to his feet by Maguire. Oh, Maguire, here comes the referee to take a look at all of that. This all happening at the Gallagher end, which is where Newcastle are playing towards in the first half. We have just over a minute of normal time remaining in the first half. 0-0, and Trippier just rolling his socks up as he gets ready to take the corner. The referee still speaking to Cher and Maguire, who's the man marking him. The two number fives going head to head. Bruno Guimaraes is there. Joel Linton, Lascelles and Isak. Lots of aerial ability in this Newcastle team. Almiron lurking in and around the penalty spot, and Miley at the far post. Trippier finally gets the cue from the referee to deliver. Can Newcastle find themselves a breakthrough potentially here? Trippier whips it high to the far post. Isak peeled away, knocked it down. Only half cleared. Smash goals by Sharon. The deflection takes it looping up into the sky. Good header out of defence by Harry Maguire. And Garnacho will try and keep it in on the near side. The lefty can't do so. Throw to Newcastle. Bruno Guimaraes to take, still 0-0.
Yeah, they're making life very uncomfortable for Onana. He's looking to come and get things, but they're getting a blocker in and around him, and he's getting just penned in.
They have certainly targeted the Manchester United goalkeeper, and now an opportunity for a curling shot over the top, all the way over the top from Cher, right-footed, and that will take us into first-half stoppage time, of which will be just a single minute, and it's almost a shame that a first-half as good as this has to end.
It is. I was hoping for about 10 minutes of any time there, Joe. The game's that good.
And it does mean we can get back into the press room, warm up at half-time. Goal kick to Manchester United away to the right. And Onana will take a lot of supporters now heading for the concourse areas. Erik ten Hag's gone back to sit down in his technical area with the coaching team, Mitchell van der Gaag and Steve McLaren, who I saw walking towards the tunnel after the warm-up earlier. And there's a free kick to Manchester United now. Scott McTominay's gone down just inside the Newcastle half. And I think it was a challenge by Joel Linton, he just caught him. I think you have to credit the resilience of Manchester United at times in the first half tonight. McTominay not happy with the challenge on him.
I think it's more fortunate resilience, to be fair. The word resilience would be throwing your body in the way, stopping things, doing this, doing that. And I think it's probably more down to Newcastle's ineptitude in finding a killer pass or a killer finish,
which is unlike them at home so far this season. 0-0 it remains. McTominay back on his feet and darting up the right hand side, couldn't find Martial with the pass in field. Martial selected ahead of Hoyland tonight. Hoyland, who is on the bench, hasn't scored in the Premier League since arriving at the club. The ball is with Rashford, back to Maynou, midway inside the Newcastle half, and the referee brings a thrilling first 45 minutes to an end here on Tyneside, live on TalkSport. Newcastle have had the Their two best opportunities of the game. Almiron denied by Onana. They're certainly targeting the Manchester United goalkeeper with aerial balls, but there would have been nothing that he could have done to stop Trippier's free kick late in the first half. But fortunately for Manchester United, it cannoned against the crossbar. Erik ten Hag's team have looked a threat on the break, but they haven't really carved out an opportunity themselves. It is intriguingly poised here in the northeast, and at half-time, Newcastle 0, Manchester United 0. Thank you, Reshmin. No changes through the team at half-time here at St James's Park. And the noise still thundering down from the stands. Manchester United will get the second half underway, playing from left to right towards the Gallagate end. Newcastle from right to left towards the Leeds' end in the second half. Newcastle in the black and white striped shirts, black shorts and white socks. Manchester United, the red shirts, white shorts and black socks. They go back to Onana, who gets the game back underway with a long clearance high downfield. So no changes. Newcastle, Pope in goal, Trippier, Lascelles, Cher and Livramento, the defenders, Bruno Guimaraes, Joel Linton and Miley in midfield, Almiron, Isak and Gordon up front. Manchester United, Onana, the goalkeeper, Wan-Bissaka, Maguire, Shaw and Dalot, McTominay and Maynou, with Rashford, Bruno Fernandes and Garnacho behind Martial. I'll give you the two sets of subs in just a moment. 0-0 the score as Joel Linton tears down the right-hand side, touches it further square to Almiron, who's a level with the edge of the 18-yard area. Lots of Newcastle fans returning to their seats early in the second half here. Feels like it's got even colder in the northeast. Freezing conditions. Almiron all left foot, corner of the penalty area, looking to set up Joel Linton. Almiron plays it backwards to Bruno Guimaraes. He's about 25 yards out, faced up by a sea of red shirts in front of him. Now Livramento, corner of the penalty area on the near side, drives infield, onto his right foot, thinks about a shot, lays it square. Almiron rolls it towards goal. In fact, it's drifting well wide, and Onana plunges on the loose ball. So 0-0, Newcastle have had the better of it, but how much encouragement will Erik ten Hag take, Stuart Pearce?
Well, the big encouragement comes when he looks at the scoreboard and Newcastle's scoreline is naught at the moment. That's the biggest encouragement he'll get. He'll know his team have got the ability to score a goal out of nothing. And the longer the game goes on with Newcastle not scoring, with these chances or half chances they're creating, entries into the box. We just had another one there with Livramento, who should have come inside and unloaded a shot. He took too long and then end up passing.
Bruno Guimaraes breaking into the box after a quick free kick. He pulls it across. Shaw there with the interception. Crucial interception. Otherwise, Isak would have had a tap in. It's a corner to Newcastle, and that underlines exactly what you've been saying all evening, Stuart, about the importance of Luke Shaw to Manchester United.
Yeah, as I say, positionally absolutely outstanding. You know, got himself just in front of Isak, made sure he couldn't receive the ball, and he got first contact and just cut out, popped it behind for a corner.
Early in the second half, 0-0. Our commentary position right behind the dugouts on the halfway line, a few feet from the touchline. Corner from Trippier, drilled in high towards Fabian Scher. It's spun off the head of Harry Maguire, nodded further clear by Martial, only as far as Joel Linton. Live on TalkSport, back to goal, lays it wide to the near side, and Gordon tries to drive it across. Wan-Bissaka is there again. Second corner in quick succession for Newcastle, and Anthony Gordon, the former Everton man, waves his arms up into the air, tries to get the Newcastle fans going. They're all on their feet at the Leeds' end, which is where the Manchester United fans are housed too, right at the very top of the stand. Steep drop down to the goal mouth below. Trippier has come across now to take the corner, and this one will be a right-footed in-swinger, and he's been whipping those right underneath the crossbar to really test out Andre Onana. Lots of players in the six-yard box.
Edge of the box is on here. I don't know whether he can pick Almiron out. Everyone's in the six-yard box.
Well, with Trippier's quality, he probably can. Trippier swung this in high to the six-yard area, and Onana punches away two-handed, high up into that dark-like sky. Beneath the floodlights here at St James's, little flick on by Isak, hooked away by McTominay to the relative safety of the halfway line. But the pattern of play in the second half, just like the first. Newcastle on the attack. Lascelles jumps, it drops to the far post. Cher pulls it across, steered away by Shaw from in front of goal. Little touch by Cher to try and flick it into the path of Almiron. This time it's intercepted by Martial. Manchester United very much on the back foot. Cleared away by Shaw again. Now Garnacho trying to get on the break. He's hardly had a chance to run at Trippier, who slides in. And that's out of play for a Manchester United throw. Erik ten Hag watches on hands in pockets on the edge of the technical area, turns back towards the dugout, 0-0. But you have to wonder for how much longer, the way that Newcastle are really imposing themselves on this game, and of course they've had a lot of success at home in the Premier League this season.
Yeah, they certainly are, and they look as though they just want it a little bit more, little challenges, 50-50s, headers. Newcastle players are coming out on top a little bit too regularly for my liking if you're a Manchester United fan.
4.5 minutes into the second half and goalless it remains. The Manchester United technical director Darren Fletcher is sitting right behind us in the commentary box. Manchester United faced 14 shots in the first half, the most in the first half of a Premier League game that they faced for over a year, but they haven't conceded as yet. And remember, they have won their last four on the road in the Premier League. They've got the ball with Shaw on the halfway line, the left-sided centre-half, the noise of 50,000 Newcastle supporters raining down towards the field of play. Forward by Maynou, little touch by Bruno Fernandes, but he couldn't keep hold of possession. A loose ball dropped to Joel Linton, lays it wide to the near side, taken in his stride by Gordon. Gordon the penalty area, full to Livramento on the underlap. Rashford tracking back, and he does enough. But Livramento's laid it back to Gordon, and Gordon gets the second ball back from Joel Linton, pulls it across, cleared away, only as far as the edge of the penalty area. Joel Linton once more, now Bruno Guimaraes with the dyed blonde hair, spins away from Bruno Fernandes, out to Livramento, now back to the Lippler centre circle and Cher. Newcastle moving the ball quickly and impressively, long diagonal ball from Cher. Trippier's kept that in by the corner flag, and then he's nutmegged Garnacho, and he steered it to the edge of the penalty area, well intercepted by Bruno Fernandes. Everything about that was good from Trippier, bar the eventual ball, and now Martial leading a counter for Manchester United. He's held it up on the transition, and they go back to the halfway line, 0-0, 6 minutes into the second half on TalkSport.
Super quality there by Trippier, once again, A, keeping the ball in play, and secondly, a clever little nutmeg, but his pass was... Well, I'm not sure who he was trying to pick out. If there was a player there, it would have been wonderful.
Relentlessly quick pace to this game.
Small details, eh? Small details.
If somebody had been there, then it would have been perfect. Stuart Pearce is with us on Talk Sport. And Harry Maguire scoops the ball high down the Manchester United right. Towering header clear by Cher. What about those subs? The two goalkeepers for Newcastle, Dubravka and Karius, then Dummett, Ritchie, Kraft, Hall, and then the three youngsters, Murphy, Parkinson and Amadou Diallo, who you had when you were at West Ham, Stuart, in the academy.
Yeah, delighted to see him here, you know, on the bench up at Newcastle and doing well, obviously, for himself.
Rashford shoving the back of Livramento, free kick to Newcastle just inside opposition territory. The Manchester United subs, outside by India, the goalkeeper, Lindelof, Amrabat, Hoyland, Reguilón, Varane, Anthony, Palistri and Van der Beek. Shaw on the cover has to step out of defence towards the right back position. He was under pressure from Joel Linton, who forces the error and the throw. What a remarkable transformation Joel Linton's had, by the way, since he was converted to a midfield player a couple of seasons ago.
I really enjoy watching him now, I've got to say. You know, he's led the battle. I think he's bullied McTominay in many ways, aerial challenges and one thing another. And you've just seen exactly what I was on about there. Him in a Newcastle shirt has bullied Luke Shaw and managed to get a throw-in for his team in the final third where it didn't look possible.
So goalless at St James's. The Sunday session returns to TalkSport tomorrow with Adrian Durham. We'll have England's tour of the Caribbean in the cricket getting underway on TalkSport 2 and our new cricket YouTube channel. And then for Monday at 6 a.m, Jeff Stelling hosts TalkSport Breakfast for the first time alongside Ali McCoist with the best of the reaction to the weekend's action. White and Jordan from 10 till 1, and Graham Souness will be with White and Jordan every Monday morning. Cannot wait for that either. The biggest names on the world's biggest sports radio station, that is Talk Sport, with all the festive football to come, 50 games over the festive period. And the best way to be across it all, you've got to get the Talk Sport app. It's free, it's easy to download, and you can swipe between both stations at your leisure. Now then, Cher for Newcastle, striding forward and angling the pass left to Livramento, who's got a long-sleeve shirt on for the second half, and he gets beyond Rashford with ease, races towards the edge of the 18-yard line, 0-0, Livramento has to cut back onto his right side, and then he just rolls it backwards into the path of Isak. Isak is about 5 yards from the dead ball line here, held up at Shaw, by Shaw at walking pace. Has to go back up wide to Livramento. Manchester United defend it well. 9 minutes into the second half. Crossfield ball hanging through the air by Bruno Guimaraes. Lovely elegant sweep on that pass to the right and Trippier. Infield to Joel Linton. Spins, turns. Can he play it forward? He shoots left footed. Straight to Onana. He had that little run from Bruno Guimaraes. Eventually went for goal. Onana with a simple save.
Yeah, I've been impressed once again with Joel Linton. Got the ball. Great receiving skills there. And he's almost bullied McTominay again. Pulled him around. Just couldn't. Once again, failed to get a meaningful finish.
Here come Newcastle again. Bruno Guimaraes, edge of the penalty area, plays it forward, Kieran Trippier crosses! Gordon traps it in! Newcastle lead! And St James's Park goes mad! That, you have to say, was a goal that's been coming! Anthony Gordon tapping home in the far post. Manchester United's defence is finally breached. Newcastle get it right again in the final third. It's Newcastle 1, Manchester United 0. And they're waving their black and white scarves and flags all around the ground.
Well, they got every piece of the jigsaw correct there, in the right order, on the right way, on the right timing. Magnificent finish, worked it out wide, lovely slid ball out wide, and when it come across the face of the goal, the easiest of finishes you would like to see from a wide player. Just a little tap in at the far post, and will that open the floodgates?
He couldn't miss. Nothing that Onana could do. Manchester United sluggish in the second half. Is that fair, Stuart?
Well, Newcastle have played a big part in that, Joe, I've got to say, because for the vast, most of this game, they've put Manchester United on the back foot. They've just failed to do what they've done in the last couple of seconds, put the ball in the back of the net. They deserve that, there's no doubt about it. Their play deserves it.
It's bouncing in the stands now, and a big roar as Gordon wins it back off Wan-Bissaka. Deep inside the Manchester United half, goes on the outside, crosses, cleared away by Maguire. Manchester United need to get a grip on the game. All of the players with Newcastle who need 1-0.
So body language plays a big part in football, and the Newcastle players there, it was Gordon chasing down Wan-Bissaka on that occasion. Prior to that, it's been Joe Linton that's been put Shaw on his backside, and they just wanted that little bit more as a team.
What a day of football we've brought you in the Premier League and the Championship on the TalkSport Network. Arsenal 4 points clear at the top after beating Wolves earlier. Brentford 3, Luton 1, Burnley 5, Sheffield United 0 was on TalkSport 2. Big win for Everton away at Nottingham Forest in the Championship. Leicester still the leaders after winning late at West Brom on TalkSport. And Newcastle 1-0 up here. Great floated ball over the top by Scher, nearly found Miley. Miley trying to flick it into the path of the onrushing Gordon, but he's blocked off by Maguire. Manchester United need to find some urgency in the game here. The ball's out on the Newcastle right with Almiron, who's always, of course, going to scamper infield onto his left side. Trippier plays it square in infield to Bruno Guimaraes. On to Scher. Scher, it might open up. He shoots! Just a couple of yards over the top. Sat up nicely for the centre-half. Hit it right-footed. Firm and true. Yard or two over the top of the crossbar. 1-0 Newcastle.
Well, this is a team and a football club that have got their tails up at the moment. They really are. They're on the front foot in everything they're doing there. And Shaw burst straight through the middle of the pitch. The ball sat up and just didn't get over it well enough. And Ten Hag's in consultation now about how do we stop the flow to stop another goal coming in. And more importantly, how do we go about getting a goal ourselves?
Yes, he's talking to Mitchell van der Gaag at the moment. A few yards in front of us in the dugout. Big problems for Manchester United. Newcastle lead 1-0. 13 minutes into the second half on Talk Sports. And we mentioned Fabian Scher there. His Switzerland team will be in Scotland's group at Euro 2024. Scotland with Switzerland, Hungary and Germany. So Scotland will have the opening game. We heard from Steve Clark, the Scotland boss, earlier on. If Wales managed to get through the playoffs, they would face Netherlands, France and Austria. And remember, England will play Denmark, Slovenia and Serbia at the Euros. Every game of the Euros will be on the TalkSport Network, as you'd expect. Gordon racing down the near side of the left, the goal scorer, and teasing Wan-Bissaka. Wan-Bissaka, that was superb. to stretch back there and pull it away from Gordon. It looked like he'd got clear, but that, as you say, Stuart Pearce, is an example of how he's so good in one-on-one situations, Wan-Bissaka.
Yeah, it's a great match-up, those two players. I've got to say, it's enjoyable for me to watch a winger and a fullback go at it.
A big cheer from the Newcastle fans. It's because the clearance has gone straight out of play, and a throw to Newcastle, far side the right, and now they're racing forward again. Almiron curling it left-footed, it's blocked by Shaw, up goes the ball into the air, punched away by Onana, that's dropped down inside the penalty area. Manchester United trying to scramble it clear. It's one-way traffic at the moment, from right to left, Newcastle coming forward, and it's all Newcastle, swarming all over Manchester United here, territorially dominant, dominant in possession. Trippier, dead ball line, can he set up another? Crosses to the near post and it's gathered by Onana, and here comes Rasmus Højlund for Manchester United.
It's situations like this is why Manchester United get questioned about leadership within their ranks. You know, they're just meandering along, letting Newcastle bully them physically and bully them with the football as well, and someone's got to put a marker down and say this isn't acceptable and stem the flow.
Anthony will also take to the field alongside Rasmus Højlund. Well, you're looking at the senior players to do that. You're looking at your captain, Bruno Fernandes, to do that, surely.
Well, right through the ranks, all it takes is someone to go and win a 50-50 tackle, someone go and win a header, someone do a burst running lung in behind the opposition's defence to receive a ball and make a bad ball a good one. I'm not seeing any United players doing that at the moment, but I tell you what, I'm seeing the people in the stripy shirts do it.
An hour gone, Newcastle 1-0 down. Off go both Rashford and Martial, both very disappointing tonight. On come Anthony and Højlund. A little shake of the hand from Erik ten Hag for the two subs as they come off. My producer just sent us some stats. Producer Deck, yes, along with the heated relay. 18 shots to 2 in Newcastle's favour so far. And it absolutely feels like that. So 1-0 to Newcastle on TalkSport with Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Whatever the mission, home or away, Enterprise helps over 120,000 people every day. What can Højlund and Anthony do now that they're on the field? Manchester United have a free kick midway inside Newcastle territory, and Pope hasn't had a save to make yet.
Yeah, you asked the question about what can United do, where's the leadership, that type of thing. They leave it to managers and coaches to try and change things by making substitutions, and that's part of their job to do that. But they've almost got to do it because none of the players on the pitch are grabbing the game by the scruff of the neck and trying to change the ascendancy that Newcastle have got.
Had been the form team in the Premier League, Manchester United, but all of their Premier League points this season have come against teams who are in the bottom half of the table at the start of the weekend. Haven't picked up a point against a team in the top half at the start of the weekend are coming into this game. Bruno Fernandes and Shaw over the ball. 10 yards infield from the far side of the left. Shaw lofted in high. Harry Maguire far post, a looping header. And you can tell from the ironic cheers that's ended up in the Gallagher end.
Yeah, unfortunate that. Good run there by Maguire, and it's landed squarely on his forehead. And just the curl of the ball, sometimes you get that timing slightly wrong and it just, you can't bring it back round on the target.
Cher tying his laces, I think, momentarily there. Martino Livramento has been called over to the near side by Eddie Howe. They do not have a great number of reinforcements, certainly in terms of a senior experienced players on the bench. Newcastle, so many out injured. It's about 10 or so. Of course, Sandro Tonali unavailable due to his ban as well. So the squad is stretched, and the 11 that are on the field are the same 11 who played the full 90-plus in Paris in the Champions League in midweek. Foul on the halfway line, free kick Newcastle.
I've just seen another instance there where the ball's been played into midfield. It's a sharing ball, it's a fighting ball. And Joe Linton's the one who says, get out my way, I want this, I want it more than you. And that probably sums up why the scoreline is what it is at the moment. And luckily for Manchester United, it's not more.
1-0 to Newcastle over an hour played on Talk Sports with Now. Don't forget that with Now you can stream all the Sky Sports action, like West Ham v Crystal Palace, Man City Tottenham, live tomorrow for £11.99, no contract. Search Now Sports. We'll take you around the grounds in the Sunday session tomorrow from 1:30.
I've got to say, I think the referee's been magnificent today.
Yeah.
They get a lot of criticism, and sometimes fairly, sometimes unfairly. I think Robert Jones has been He's got on top of things that he's had to, and he's let things go and told players, get up and get on with it. And well done to you.
And credit where credit's due. And Maynou under pressure facing his own goal, and he's steered it wide towards the left, and Dallow can't keep it in. And Manchester United have collapsed a bit in the second half, really, here. 1-0 down. Armour on call on the penalty area, out wide to Trippier. Far side the right touchline. And then Miley's touch, the 17-year-old feeding Bruno Guimaraes, taken up by Isak in his stride, edge of the box, looks for Miley once more. Miley sandwiching between two red shirts. Manchester United have virtually everybody bar Hoyland back behind the ball. Now it's Isak again, 25 yards out, he suddenly picks up the pace. Can he get the return from Bruno Guimaraes? No, when intercepted by Bruno Fernandes. Now then, here's the counter for Manchester United, Garnacho. Not seen much of him in the game, that one effort in the first half that was easily blocked by Nick Pope. And then a Newcastle player down in the centre circle, I think.
It's Gordon.
It's Gordon, yeah, you're right, you're right.
I think someone's just caught his ankle or trod on his boot at all. I'm sure in the future that these players are going to be suing the boot manufacturers, you know, for putting them out in boots. That if someone treads on you, it's like carpet slippers. It really is. They're so light these days.
And you wouldn't want that in this weather. I can't feel my toes at the moment. I need another thermal sock. That's what I need right now. 20 minutes gone in the second period. Newcastle lead Manchester United 1-0. Jason Tindall's issuing some instructions from the near side touchline. I can't quite work out exactly what he's trying to say. You might be able to. You'll certainly have a better chance than me, that's for sure.
I could make something up and make out I do, but I won't. I'm not that sort of commentator, Joe.
We're forward by Lascelles from the free kick, and he's given it straight to Andre Onana. And certainly that nothing that Onana could have done about the Newcastle goal. It was a fine move. Trippier's cross tapped in by Gordon for 1-0. Onana's high-hanging ball towards the halfway line. Header away by Lascelles. Beats Garnacho to it. Dallow twisting away from Almiron, who then slides in. We know that Manchester United are capable of scoring goals. We saw that again in midweek, but they haven't had, I suppose, the time and space to put a move together in the game so far. Shaw gets across in front of Miley in the left-back position again. He has no other option but to knock it out of play. That's another throw to Newcastle. And every Newcastle piece of effort, or every throw, every corner, every set-piece one is being cheered by fans who leap out of their seats. And, of course, there's a fan who doesn't need a coat on. He's just got his Newcastle black and white shirt on the far side of the field, and he's standing out of his seat almost in celebration. Here they are on the attack, Cher sliding beyond three Manchester United players and knocking it wide to Trippier. And there's a Manchester United player down, and it's been put out of play rather sporting in the end by Newcastle. It's Bruno Fernandes who's gone down.
I'll tell you what's happened here. The ball's come between Cher. I've got to say, that was a poor, poor challenge. He's ended up rolling his foot over the top of Fernandes's ankle. He's caught him pretty badly. I've got to say, I was about to be a little bit critical there. Looked like one player wanting it more than the other, but he's certainly gone through.
Late challenge and a poor one from Fabian Cher. And Bruno Fernandes making the point to the referee, gesticulating as if to describe the challenge itself. And frustration for the Manchester United captain, but Newcastle heading for their sixth consecutive Premier League home win. They've already beaten Aston Villa, Brentford, Burnley, Crystal Palace, Arsenal and Chelsea here at St James's Park. And Bruno Fernandes has got the physio on now, and Erik ten Hag's in conversation with Steve McClaren a few yards in front of us on the near side touchline. Manchester United haven't been able to get themselves into the game as an attacking force really at all in this second half, and we're already midway through the second period on Talk Sport. Game day back next Saturday, by the way. Crystal Palace against Liverpool, Blackburn against Leeds, and Wolves against Nottingham Forest will be our commentaries. On Tuesday, we've got a big game in the Women's Nations League. Must win for England away at Scotland. That'll be on Talk Sport 2. And Monday morning from 6 a.m, Jeff Stelling starts in the breakfast hot seat alongside Ali McCoist. Now then, Bruno Fernandes is back on his feet. Manchester United will be temporarily down to 10.
Yeah, they will be. And as I say, they're going to need the tide to turn. The substitutes have not done that in any way, shape or form at this moment in time. And I think from Newcastle's point of view, Joe, they'll be desperate to get this second goal and kill this game off and put it to bed.
It does feel like a second would wrap it up in a fixture that's had a great history over years gone by. Gordon, the goal scorer, the number 10 in the left wing position, back to Livramento. Now it's Cher on the halfway line, directly in line with our commentary position. Now Lascelles with the mint-coloured boots on, out to the right side, and Trippier, who set up the goal, forward to Bruno Guimaraes, quickly, looking to spin away from Shaw down the right. Shaw tracking his every move, probably been Manchester United's best player. The ball is out of play for United, a Manchester United throw in their left-back position. Dalot will come forward to take it as Erik ten Hag just looks at the ground, wearing that flat cap and the overcoat. Manchester United have got more subs warming up. I think Palistri is one of those. And Newcastle win a throw, and it continues to look comfortable for Eddie Howe's team. But of course, as we know in the Premier League, a 1-0 lead is a very slender one. Joel Linton forward to Gordon, who's worked the angle inside the centre circle to play it square to Bruno Guimaraes. Atmosphere has just dropped slightly in the last few moments, but here comes Trippier taking a lovely pass out of the air. Corner of the penalty area, Trippier rifles one goalwards, but didn't really get enough behind it. A miss hit, really. That's going to bobble wide for a goal kick.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether Trips was looking to drive across in there or a shot. It was an angled ball. I'm not really sure what it was, if I'm being honest with you. It wasn't good enough to be a shot, and it wasn't bad enough to be a cross. It
there's something in the middle of those two.
Joe Linton has just gone and pressed Wan-Bissaka, run over the top of him and got a throw-in for his team in the final third, where they should have got nowhere near that ball just then.
Joe Linton outstanding tonight. Newcastle 1, Manchester United 0. Into the last 20 minutes. The latest odds with Betfair, our official betting partner. Newcastle to win at 11-2 on. Manchester United to win at 25-1. They've given away a free kick now, midway inside their own half. In fact, it's about 6 or 7 yards from the edge of the box, so a dangerous position. You can back the draw at 9-2. Don't forget Betfair are paying out winning bets at 90 minutes with 90 minute payout. Applies to match odds, 90 market or markets with the 90 icon. That's all thanks to Betfair. 18 plus. BeGambleAware.org.
It's interesting that stat that you said that Manchester United have not beaten anyone in the top half of the league. Was that correct?
Yeah, top half of the start of this weekend. Yeah.
Well, that tells you something, doesn't it? You know, it means that they play the game and they're good enough ability wise to win the game. But when the games are in the balance, like today is, they certainly look wanting.
Standing over this free kick is Trippier for Newcastle United. Having set up one goal already, right footed in swinging for once a poor delivery. It hit, well, not the first man, the second man, Garnacho. Swept away by Bruno Fernandes up to halfway. Anthony has got Hoyland square if he can see him. Hoyland edge of the centre circle. Can he poke it onto Garnacho? No. Lascelles racing back to win it back for Newcastle. And just as Manchester United had a sight of an opportunity on the transition, Lascelles was there, the captain, to snuff it out. Newcastle still lead 1-0. And here's Cher. On to Joel Linton on the halfway line, trying to check back inside away from Wan-Bissaka. Right in front of us, Joel Linton wins a throw. A great athlete, Joel Linton, but a very cultured player too. Eddie Howe gets out of his seat in the dugout. There have been great performances all over the pitch for Newcastle so far tonight, but there's still over 17 minutes left.
Yeah, this is the nature of football at the highest level in England, that you can dominate games and still not take the points at the end of the match. So they'll be acutely aware of that, Newcastle.
There are some Brazilian flags dotted around the stadium, including one at the Gallagate end. Foul this time on Joel Linton. Free kick taken quickly by Bruno Guimaraes, but the referee, Rob Jones, wasn't ready. He wants it brought back to where it should be taken, just 8-9 yards or so into Manchester United territory. Manchester United who host Chelsea next. In fact, three home games to come. Chelsea, Bournemouth, and the huge game in the Champions League against Bayern Munich.
I'm just seeing one of them Hardy Toon fans with his shirt off totally now. There's no need for that.
Well, there's always one or two here though, right? We know that. Floated forward by Trippier from the free kick. It's getting colder here. Headed away by Maguire, brought down by Bruno Guimaraes. Always a great pleasure to be at St James's Park, one of the great theatres of the Premier League. And Manchester United win a throw just shy of the halfway line. They've got just over 15 minutes of normal time to go here to get themselves an equaliser. At the moment, if we're totally truthful, it doesn't really feel like they deserve an equaliser at this point in the game, but things can change.
Well, you've got to have an entry into the opposition's half before you get an equaliser, let's be honest with you, and they don't look as though they're going to do that.
Yeah, the positional map in the second half would be interesting, wouldn't it? The heat map of those Manchester United players. They've got the ball on the far side, the left with Shaw. Shaw crossfield, left to right to Bruno Fernandes. Well controlled inside the centre circle, held it up neatly in front of Joel Linton. Now wide to Anthony. Anthony on the right hand side. He's going to shuffle infield onto his left foot, as he likes to do. Tries to get the return from Wan-Bissaka. Who's there? Joel Linton. And then it's punted clear by Gordon down the middle. Quite a clever angled ball. Onana there, little Cruyff turn Onana away from Isak. Did well, the goalkeeper.
Yeah, really good ball there by Gordon. Just put too much pace on it and not enough fade to kill the pace of it. If he would have done, Isak could have got on the end of it.
Newcastle United 1, Manchester United 0 on Talk Sport. 15 minutes left. Bruno Fernandes is 30 yards out and dead centre. No way he can have the shot. Had to go wide to Anthony. Anthony touches it on to Wan-Bissaka by the dead ball line. Anthony again. Couple of yards from the corner flag. Back it goes to Bruno Fernandes once more. Hoyland's in the middle. It's played low along the ground to Garnacho. Garnacho can't control in front of Miley. Poor control, or an attempt at control, by Garnacho. And now it's Trippier trying to surge over the halfway line for Newcastle. He's got Isak to his immediate right. Isak controls, the tall, slender striker who's one shy of double figures for the season so far. Fight night with Adam Catchell to come on Talk Sport once we're done here at St James's Park. And Joel Linton prompts the ball wide to the left with the outside of his foot to find Livramento. Touches it onto the goal scorer Gordon. 1-0 Newcastle lead. Livramento on the overlap. High looping left footed cross. And that's drifted over the top of Onana's crossbar. And that will be a goal kick to Manchester United.
Yeah, I'm sure Eddie Howe at this stage would have loved to have the likes of Murphy to come off the bench and have impact and another threat in these advanced areas, and probably Wilson as well, just to finish the game off and get the team over the line.
Yes, Byrne and Botman and Barnes and Target and others on the treatment table at Newcastle. And no Elliot Anderson either. Stamped forward by Bruno Fernandes from Manchester United, high up the middle and intercepted by Cher. Lovely skillful play by Cher to juggle it away from the onrushing Garnacho. Cher's still coming forward here. Gordon can poke it to the left and find him. Oh, Maguire lunged it on Gordon. He knew he had to make the tackle. It was a poorly timed one. Yellow card for Maguire. Had to be. Free kick Newcastle, they lead 1-0.
Well, it was just done by the sheer pace of Gordon there, but if he didn't make the challenge, then Newcastle are in behind and in on goal. So, well, I don't think it was actually, you know, some of these you look at and say it was a clinical challenge. I don't think it was. It was just slow and just couldn't get there in time.
Eric Ten Hag has called over Sofyan Amrabat, I think, here. It remains to be seen whether he'll definitely come on. Big day of football in the Premier League tomorrow. You can follow it on TalkSport Sunday session from 1:30. We'll be based at the Etihad ahead of Manchester City against Tottenham. Liverpool, Fulham and Chelsea, Brighton, Bournemouth, Villa, West Ham, Palace, the games. And Newcastle, at least temporarily, heading at fifth in the Premier League. Here is Trippier. Forward from the halfway line, Lascelles let it run, got the call from Joel Linton in space down the left. Joel Linton bursts into the box, drives it low across the face of goal, and the shot is blocked right on the edge of the six-yard line. Newcastle want handball, Miley denied. The referee says corner, but you can see that Rob Jones, hand to his earpiece, is in communication with the VAR.
This is either a world-class stop or a penalty. I don't know which. He was right in front of the goalkeeper. Oh, it's hit his body and shot up and hit his arm. I don't think that'll be given. Probably his shoulder. No, not a penalty for me. Great defending by Wan-Bissaka.
Incredible block.
It certainly was. Right in front of the goalkeeper. Any deflection on target, it's a certain goal.
Mighty thought that he had that wonderful moment. It would have been his first senior goal. And Sergio Reguilón and Sofyan Amrabat ready to come on for Manchester United. Well, an incredible block by Wan-Bissaka at point blank range.
I think it might be, would it be Maguire maybe coming off, do you think, as part of this, that booking now, and It's incredible, really, that they need a goal and more defensive-minded players on.
It would be a defensive entirely of full-backs for Manchester United as well. Corner whipped in high. Joel Linton getting up. It's skimmed off his forehead. It'll be thumped up into the dark night sky and high towards the halfway line by Dallow. And with 11 minutes to go, 1-0 down Manchester United. Here come the latest set of changes. And off goes Wan-Bissaka. So here comes Reguilón. So that should be Dallow to right back. And now Amrabat also taken to the field. And that's a straight swap for Maynou.
Yeah, as I say, shuffling the pack here. The last two subs have had very, very little impact, to be fair. Whether these two will have any desired impact, who knows?
Well, a lot has been missing for Manchester United in terms of performance tonight, but it would be a relatively rare defeat in the Premier League, at least in recent times.
I don't think it's really performance that's been lacking. It's probably that little bit of desire. Newcastle have rolled them over physically, I think.
I guess in a way, is that almost even more worrying for Erik ten Hag?
Well, we've seen it a few times with United over the last year and a half. You know, they've caved in it in certain matches. We saw it against Bayern Munich this year.
10 minutes to go. Newcastle lead 1-0, and it's all Newcastle still. Playing from right to left, looking for the cushion for the second goal. Gordon trying to get beyond Dallow, blocked off. McTominay sends it back to Onana. And Onana clears high and long towards Hoyland. Hoyland trying to bring it down in front of Cher. And Bruno Guimaraes reaches the second ball in front of Bruno Fernandes and draws a foul. Clever play by Bruno Guimaraes, the Brazilian. And Bruno is the noise of the Newcastle fans, the chant of the Newcastle fans.
Take your pick which one they're singing about.
There's only one Bruno at St James's Park. Only one that the Newcastle fans are bothered about, that's for sure. Trippier plays it back to Lascelles, and now Pope, a virtual spectator in the second half, the goalkeeper, it has to be said. One save in the first half with his feet to deny Garnacho. 9 minutes to go. 1-0 to Newcastle. And still hope for Manchester United. Here is McTominay on the halfway line trying to surge forward. He's played it to the left and fed it into the path of Sergio Reguilón. On to Garnacho. Garnacho dribbling forward now with menace. Cross is deflected behind and Manchester United have a corner. That's their first corner of the night.
This is the concern for Newcastle. Absolutely dominated this game and still you have an inkling in your back of your mind that Manchester United are going to get an opportunity.
Luke Shaw will take the corner. It'll be a left-footed outswinger in front of the Gallagher end. Everybody back for Newcastle United. Hoisted in high. Headed away by Joel Linton. Reguilón on the volley. Brilliantly blocked from in front of goal. And now it's Harry Maguire with a snapshot from just inside the penalty area. And that is charged down two. Onana had to race forward to the halfway line to get to the clearance. And now Shaw. Squared infield to Dallow. Nick Pope is down, injured, the Newcastle goalkeeper. He sat in the six-yard box. Manchester United played on initially. The referee has stopped the game. Pope is hurt.
Yeah, I think he's got a problem with that left leg. It might be his knee, the way he's sort of prostrate there. It's an incredible effort. Great defending. I've not seen a collision that's caused the problem. Unless something happened slightly before that, I don't know. But he's took a big dive and stayed on the turf and not moved.
Pope is being treated in the goal mouth now. And of course, with Newcastle's dramatic injury issues, Eddie Howe doesn't want them to mount any further. What does it look like to you, Stuart?
It's that left knee. It's certainly the left knee. He's cupping it at the moment. And obviously, talking to the physios, looks as though it's locked or something of that nature. He looks very concerned about it.
Well, he was diving to try and save the Reguilón effort that was goal-bound, by the way, and brilliantly blocked by Fabian Scher. And Pope, all of a sudden, has a problem. Well, we might have quite a bit of stoppage time. 7 minutes of normal time to go. And Newcastle might have to change their goalkeeper late on in this match.
Well, they've got a couple on the bench and a couple with good experience, Dubravka and Karius.
Well, Dubravka, who was on loan at Manchester United for a bit last season, and Karius, who played against Manchester United in that League Cup final when Pope was suspended.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, he's in a bit of trouble here, Nick Pope. You can see the grimace on his face.
Well, this is a massive blow potentially for Newcastle United. Their England goalkeeper is going to be taken off here with what looks like a nasty injury. He's being helped off the field. He's got a physio holding onto his arm, and then another nearby too.
This could be his shoulder, you know, the way he's bit, whether he's got a problem with his shoulder at all. He looks as though he's craning that more so than his knee, but...
Because the physio's holding onto his arm, isn't he? So it's got to be an arm or shoulder injury.
Yeah.
So this could be a really problematic latest injury issue for Eddie Howe and Newcastle to contend with. Sometimes the innocuous ones are the ones that you worry about, and Pope is grimacing here as he leaves the field.
He might have just put his shoulder out with the dive. As I say, it was a full straight drive, and I can't for the life of me, he was literally 1 yard off the goal line, and they've walked him right across the pitch to the halfway line to take him off.
And he's walking very gingerly here, Pope, as he goes down the tunnel right in front of us. And Newcastle, well, we're still... It'll be Dubravka to come on. He's getting stripped and ready to go. The man with number one on the back of his shirt. But whatever happens tonight, and Newcastle looks set to record an impressive victory, the big downer on it from a Newcastle perspective is clearly the injury to the goalkeeper. And we will, of course, find out from Eddie Howe just exactly what's up with Nick Pope once we're done here in the game tonight. And here comes Dubravka.
Yeah, I think when you dive at full strength, I'm surprised goalkeepers don't have more of a problem with that collarbone stroke shoulder area than they actually do. But the way he was sort of sat with his legs straight, both arms were around his knee at one stage, but maybe he was just resting his shoulder.
So here comes Dubravka. Difficult for a goalkeeper coming in from the cold, unexpected, very late on in the game with a tight scoreline, Stuart.
It certainly is, but listen, if he has the same amount of work to do as Pope did for the last 86 minutes, no need to get warmed up.
On he comes, 34 years old Dubravka. His only appearance this season against Manchester United in the League Cup fourth round win, and ironically he made his debut against Manchester United in 2018. So, 4 minutes of normal time to go, Newcastle 1, Manchester United 0, Dubravka on for the injured Pope. There'll be a lot of stoppage time, and Manchester United maybe have got just a little bit of momentum in this second half finally, Stuart Pearce.
Well, listen, they've left it late if they have, but the bottom line is, you know, there's been a break in the game, and that can only help United.
Wins in the Premier League today for the leaders Arsenal, for Brentford, for Burnley, for Everton. And Chelsea, Manchester City, Liverpool all in action tomorrow on the Sunday session on TalkSport. Manchester United trail here, 1-0, very late in the game. Amrabat with the gloves on, pings it towards the right from the halfway line. Good interception by Livramento. Livramento forward now to Bruno Guimaraes, touches it on to Joel Linton, who gives it away, does he? Bruno Guimaraes hasn't been able to beat McTominay to the ball. Hoyland's battled well to knock it towards the left-hand side, and Garnacho. Garnacho in behind Trippier. Trippier did well, sliding it in a foot race, out of play for a corner.
Well, he's had to get that right, that is for sure. He's gone to ground, gone on his backside. If you mistime that, it's a penalty. Good defending, but they've got a corner to defend now.
It'll be left to Shaw to take. At the Gallagher end, less than 3 minutes of normal time to go here. Luke Shaw over the ball. He'll hoist it in high, left-footed, out swinging up towards Maguire, away by Lascelles. Reguil on the volley again, blocked by the first man, Bruno Guimaraes.
Yeah, it's all hands to the pump now for Newcastle. First time in the game that they've been under any form of pressure.
Dominated the match, but have only scored once. And can Manchester United pinch a point here late on? Good record away from home of late, Manchester United. Anthony, infield to Amrabat. Everybody's deep inside the Newcastle half, bar the Manchester United goalkeeper, Andre Onana, as time ticks on.
Maguire's taking up a decent position here, and they're going to have to mark him if they do get good supply in the box, and he pulls onto one of the fullbacks.
Maguire's up there with Hoyland as Bruno Fernandes flicks it high and deep into the penalty area. Only half cleared by Newcastle. Miley gets to the second ball. He's held it up in front of McTominay, plays it back to Trippier again. Eddie Howe maybe understandably reluctant to make any outfield changes because he just doesn't have the strength in depth on the bench to do so.
No, he doesn't, but he's got Gordon limping around at the moment.
Shaw's cross-headed away down to Ante on the volley, deflected in! Manchester United have equalised! The flag stays down and now the flag goes up! And it will be ruled out! And it will stay Newcastle 1, Manchester United 0.
Yeah, we spoke about Maguire being up in and around the box. It was him that ended up being right in front of Dubravka, and I think he's deflected the ball just off, yes, he's deflected the ball, I think, past Dubravka, right in front of the goalkeeper, definite offside.
We can see from the monitor in our commentary position that Maguire was a yard or so offside. Hit by Anthony, left-footed. Anthony not scored this season. Maguire turned it home, but the decision confirmed by the referee. And the on-field officials between them got it right there. Proof that you don't always need VAR to check everything.
No, good. Say the officials have been very, very good today, I've got to say, and the right decision, and maybe that little bit of luck, I think, that Newcastle's endeavour deserved.
So still 1-0 Newcastle. Well, that was nice. That was how we used to referee matches until about, what, a year, 18 months or so ago.
And it went out of fashion.
I've forgotten what it was like. Now then, the referee is coming across to the near side touchline, Rob Jones. Joel Linton has gone down. We've had the 90 minutes of normal time. Here comes the fourth official with that electronic board. Quick word from the captain, Lascelles, for the referee. 9 minutes of added time. 9 minutes for Manchester United to try and find an equaliser on TalkSport.
This 9 minutes is going to seem like an eternity. You know, when you've dominated a game like that, I've been in matches like this, and you think, come on, come on, blow the whistle, and 9 minutes come up on the board.
These two sides, top four rivals this season, rivals for a place in the top four, you feel. Here is Shaw, 10-yard shy of the halfway line for Manchester United. McTominay plays it back to Harry Maguire, who's midway inside his own half the field. Maguire scampering forward, and he's reached Newcastle territory, but his pass towards the right isn't a good one. Trippier intercepts with great determination and wins a throw on the far side, and the Newcastle fans are finding their voices again later on.
Yeah, and they're going to need all of their fans to get them over the line at this moment in time. As I say, it's been the best probably phase of the game that Manchester United have had. They've got nothing to lose at the moment.
Eddie Howe's name being chanted by the Newcastle supporters. Again, they get to their feet all around the stadium. A minute through, nine at it on TalkSport. Long throw down the far side right touchline. It's cleared away by Reguilón for Manchester United. Header away by Cher for Newcastle. And now Garnacho dropping into his own half and drawing a foul and winning a free kick, which Reguilón takes quickly. Pushes it on to Scott McTominay, trying to break in between the lines. Nutmegs, winning Imarish, but the pass square is intercepted by the retreating Gordon. And now Joel Linton, forward to Livramento. The tireless Livramento, fouled by Anthony on the stretch. That'll be a yellow card. Livramento beats him for pace.
I can honestly say, Joe, that phase of play there by Anthony was pathetic. His team need the game to have momentum to it. He's tracked back, he's got covering players in and around him, he's gone to ground and just tripped the Newcastle player over. Ridiculous play.
No goal, no assist in the Premier League this season for Anthony. Just over £85 million from Ajax.
What are you trying to say? Are you leading me down the road?
Well, I'm agreeing with you. Certainly based on that passage of play. Nearly 2.5 minutes through the nine added. Newcastle 1, Manchester United 0. Eddie Howe and Jason Tindall kicking every ball on the near side. Diogo Dalot for Manchester United in the right back position. Has let it trickle out of play for a throw that he will take. The Portuguese had a good run of starts in the team this season. Long throw towards Hoyland is intercepted by Cher. The ball is not where Manchester United would want it. It's inside their own territory. Bruno Fernandes, though. Good ball out to the left and Reguilón. Reguilón takes it in his stride and bursts over halfway. He's got pace, Reguilón, which is why he's been brought into the game. Out to Garnacho. Garnacho corner of the penalty area. Twisting and turning and reaching the dead ball line and hanging up the cross. McTominay went for it. I think McTominay actually diverted that away from goal. And it's thumped clear. And Isak, one-on-one here with Amrabat. Only Amrabat between him and the goal. Isak driving forward. One way and the other. He's reached the edge of the penalty area. Isak's got two in Man United red around him. He tries to beat both. Shaw and Amrabat tried to squeeze between them. No foul, says the referee.
This is where game understanding's got to come in. Isak broke. It's one-on-one, but it run aground. Once it runs aground, you've got to keep possession for your team.
3.5 minutes of stoppage time has been played. We had nine added in part because of the injury to Nick Pope, the Newcastle goalkeeper. Newcastle 1-0 up. We're live on Talk Sport. Forward by Anthony down the right. Diogo Dalot, dead ball line, crosses, headed away by Fabian Scher at the expense of a corner at the Gallagher 10.
Great defending there by Scher, got in a brilliant position, might have gone into the arms of Dubravka. He weren't to know that. He's been magnificent tonight.
And suddenly there are two balls on the pitch. I think a Newcastle fan maybe throwing the ball onto the field just as Bruno Fernandes was about to take the corner. Here he goes, the captain, right footed, out swinging, high towards Harry Maguire, headed away. Towers, Trent, Jamal Lascelles. Newcastle nearly there. Bruno Guimaraes on the charge up to the halfway line. It's been sent back by Shaw to Andre Onana, the goalkeeper. 4.5 minutes through the nine added, halfway through stoppage time. As Stuart Pearce said, it'll feel like an eternity to the Newcastle fans, players and staff. Garnacho infield from the left. Was he tripped? He was. Free kick.
I tell you what, I think Eddie Howe, if I was him, I'd probably bring a couple of players on, maybe for Gordon certainly, and Isaac. They look very, very leggy at this moment in time, just to give energy to the team.
Incredible effort from Newcastle after their Champions League exertions in midweek. I think Jason Tindall's passed a note to the fourth official, so maybe there will be changes on the way. But they've got to defend the free kick first. It's just about level with the edge of the 18-yard line. A couple of yards infield from the far side, the Manchester United left, and it's Bruno Fernandes over the ball. Still 4 minutes of added time to go. Long line of players on the edge of the box. Everybody virtually in that 18-yard area. Hoisted in high by Bruno Fernandes, and Dubravka manages to take it at the second attempt, and now he is bending forward as though he was possibly slightly injured there, but now he's okay again, I think, Dubravka. Good take from the goalkeeper in the end, and he's now being urged by the referee to keep the game going. Well, never easy for a goalkeeper to come into any game late on. Patted the ball down and gathered it at the second attempt, and it's still 1-0 Newcastle.
Give his team a massive lift that coming to claim that cross.
Dubravka belts the ball high up the pitch, headed away by Shaw. Amrabat forward for Manchester United to the halfway line. Anthony lays it back to Dalot. Dalot charged down by Gordon, but the deflection is spooned into the path of Anthony, who can't get beyond the tireless Joel Linton and Bruno Guimaraes. It's given away though by the 17-year-old Miley. The tired bodies and maybe some tired minds for Newcastle here. It's Harry Maguire in the right back position, in the right wing position, blocked off by Joel Linton, who gestures towards the fans and he wants even more noise. Newcastle fans reciprocate. They're out of their seats. 6.5 minutes of the nine added have been played. Still a single goal between them. Matt Ritchie's going to come on for Newcastle here.
Yeah, Joe Linton's got to do the things that's made him such an impressive competitor today. Not get involved in stupidity by challenges or harangue officials at this moment in time.
Well, it's Gordon coming off, the man who looks like he scored the winning goal. And on in his place, Matt Ritchie, very experienced, of course. One moment when Newcastle capitalised on finding gaps at the back. So Ritchie onto the field, a throw to Manchester United, near side the right. Dalot goes backwards to Bruno Fernandes. In fact, he's going to have to take it again.
I think Ritchie here needs to stay close to Fernandes. Don't worry about the ball, they'll deal with that behind you. If it comes back to Fernandes, that ball's coming in the box.
Newcastle with everybody back. Manchester United, plenty of red shirts in and around the 18-yard box. 90 seconds to go. They're 1-0 down. St. James's Park is on its collective feet. Amrabat down by the corner flag here, trying to tease it across. He does to the near post, but Joel Linton, ever the favourite to reach it, is there to intercept. And he races to the touchline, and he's shrugged aside by Hoyland. And that's out of play for a throw to Manchester United. Dalot will take it.
This is what I never understand, Joe. When you're time-wasting, you're happy to take it into the opposition's corner flag and keep it. Why don't you take it into your own corner flag and keep it?
Well, we've only got over a minute to go. Dallow's long throw towards Hoyland. He flicks it on and Amrabat sends it skywards and high and over the top, behind for a goal kick. And Manchester United are very nearly beaten here as Erik ten Hag, glum-faced, turns back towards the dugout. Newcastle lead 1-0. And they're starting to bay the referee for the final whistle, the home supporters.
Yeah, they certainly are. There was talk about which one of these two teams would be more up for the contest. Well, I think we've seen the answer to that over 97, 99 minutes. It's been Newcastle.
Great noise all around the stadium. 30 seconds left. Newcastle heading for another home win. headed away by Livramento towards the halfway line. Joel Linton battles again in between Maguire and Dalot and wins the free kick, much to Manchester United's displeasure. But that sums up Joel Linton's display. It sums up Newcastle's display.
Yeah, he's taken the fight. There's no doubt about that. He's taken the fight to the opposition, Joel Linton. And the more I watch him, the more impressed I am with him, his stature as a player.
Well, we've had the 9 minutes of stoppage time. Newcastle 1, Manchester United 0. The home supporter ready for the final whistle. Free kick just lofted forward by Scher down the left-hand side. It's going to sweep out of play. Referee's had a look at the watch. A throw to Manchester United in their right-back position. Diogo Dalot will take it. Newcastle fans whistling, appealing to the referee to end the game. Dalot's throw forward to Hoyland. What's he doing back there? He's been dispossessed. Surely he should be further upfield. Driven long by Dalot. Still we play on. Nearly 10 minutes of added time, but Kieran Trippier's won it back down the Newcastle right the far side. He's teed it forward towards Almiron. Almiron down by the corner flag. They're going to head for the corner flag here, surely. Trying to get it beyond Harry Maguire. And the referee has blown the final whistle. And it's a massive win for Newcastle United. Their sixth successive Premier League home victory. Manchester United are beaten on the road. Erik ten Hag's team, when it comes to away games in particular against the top opposition, are once more found wanting. But a week for Newcastle United that began with disappointment and heartbreak in Paris, the late penalty that went against them, is ending with delight here on Tyneside. Home comforts once again for Eddie Howe's team. Depleted they are, so many injuries that they have, but they are delighted, the Geordie supporters, with the performance that they've seen tonight. Anthony Gordon with the winning goal in the second half. Manchester United had very little, if anything, in response. A deeply disappointing few days for Erik ten Hag's team, particularly after the draw in Galatasaray, to follow it up with a meek and limp performance today. The Manchester United fans are quickly heading out of the Leeds' end, but the Newcastle fans will start the party now. They're up to fifth in the table. It has finished Newcastle United 1, Manchester United 0.